This meditation is dedicated to the 15th blessing of the Amida, where we connect to and bless the world with Mashiach and it's not so clear whether Mashiach is a person or a state of consciousness. It seems to me that it's both. So I'd like to connect with that capacity for redemption inside of each of us, and that collective capacity for redemption within the entirety of the Jewish people and with all of humanity as a whole. With that being said, I invite you to close your eyes and place your precious hands over your beautiful heart. And feel the simple act of redemption that is happening right now. The breath of life that is animating you again and again. If, like me, you have been sick this winter, you know how incredible it is to simply be able to breathe. To feel your lungs expand. Become filled with the soul of life. And as you slow down your breathing, really taking the time to extend the exhale. I invite you to feel the very detail of it. How far does your chest expand? Notice how your ribs open and close. Feel how this breath is massaging the organs of your belly. As your belly expands and your diaphragm falls, and you can choose if you want to You feel your breath as a caress. As a loving, soft holding. As a whisper from the divine. And as you keep your focus on that space under your hands, I invite you to also expand your peripheral awareness far beyond the reaches of your body. Far into the unknown. Where all of the potential futures lay. Where the divine plan is sparkling. And you open your heart. The unknown. To a future redemption that you neither know nor understand. And with this presence in your heart and also expansion in your mind, allow yourself to go back in time to when you were a slave in Egypt. And your body wanted to buckle under the strain of the whip. And feel how your body wants to curl in into fear and sadness and anger. But I invite you to choose instead to use that mind of yours to expand your awareness into the myriad possibilities. Because your parents told you that your great-great-great-grandfather, Abraham, was given a promise. That you would come back out of this darkness and out of this slavery. Come back into freedom. Through miraculous means. Through signs and wonders. And that you would come back home. To the Holy Land. Is a holy nation. Under a holy God. And feel your heart expanding with the wonder of that promise. Even as you feel the whip on your back, feeling your gaze expanding far in every direction into the unknown, into the realm of the miraculous. Where a redemption that you couldn't possibly ever imagine is awaiting you. If it was the known, it wouldn't be a miracle. And Hashem promised he would work in mysterious ways and redeem his people. So I invite you to see and hear Moshe coming to you for the first time. And letting you know that this is the time, the signs and the wonders. And feel how your body wants to buckle against the Master's whip and close off to this promise of Moshe. But choose nonetheless to expand your gaze. And to smile and to believe. To be one of those 20% of the Jews who believed in Hashem's promise. So see yourself taking a goat or a lamb and tying it to your bedpost and giving it to the man. The whip no longer owns you. You are free because you've given yourself over to a promise. That you believe despite not knowing or understanding how it will unfold. And in the midst of the cries of Egypt, feel yourself gathering your people, your flocks, your unleavened bread, and heading out into the wilderness to follow the voice of the unknown. As you hear freedom beckoning, and feel yourself walking between the walls of water and the sea of reeds, and allow a smile to come upon your face as you dance on this miraculously dry land and rejoice in miracles you couldn't possibly have predicted. And now feel yourself dancing with Miriam and singing with your nation and playing the tambourines. Heeding the call of Moshe, as you follow him in the desert with clouds of glory and with fire, and feel your hands coming down on the earth and lifting up the man, the bread of heaven, and bring it to your lips. You're not just surrounded by miracles, you get to taste them with every fiber of your being. This is your heritage. Your soul lived this story. Your soul tasted this man. And your soul received the Torah at Sinai. The Torah that promised that our nation would be scattered to the four corners of the earth, but that eventually we would come home. And hear the calls of the prophets who promise that our dry bones would reanimate themselves, that a new temple would arise in Jerusalem, and that a leader would come with signs and wonders and lead us into an age of peace, of light, of unity, of love. And just like Hashem's promise to Abraham came true, and just like you got to live that promise in action, so too Hashem's promise of the final redemption is coming true through you and through me and through all of the Israeli nation. Through every single one of the children of Israel We are living this redemption. And we are hungry for leadership that will guide us towards ultimate peace and ultimate unity and ultimate truth. And with your words and with your faith and with the light of your heart, you can bring that leader closer and closer to revealing themselves. So first I invite us to make the call of unity by together saying the words of the Shema 3 times. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. And we are seeking leadership. We are seeking the moon that reflects the light of the great sun. Because really we want to be led by the King of Kings, by the Holy One himself. And we will bring down his light by saying 3 times, Hashem Melech, Hashem Malach, Hashem Yimloch Leolam Vayed. Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch Leolam Vayed. Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch Leolam Vaed. Again, Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch Leolam Vaed. And one more time, Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch Leolam Vaed. And because we are seeking now in this time of darkness redemption above everything else, we will make the call of redemption that we make during Hallel. Anna Adonai Hoshia Na. Anna Adonai Hoshia Na. Anna Adonai Hatzlicha Na. Anna Adonai Hatzlicha Na. And all of this beautiful light of redemption that is in you and around you now and at all times, choose to feel it in your heart and choose to expand its reach well beyond the limitations of your body, from one end of the universe to the other. Ah. Ana Adonai Hoshia Na. Ana Adonai Hoshia Na. Ana Adonai Hatzlicha Na. Ana Adonai Hatzlicha Na. And in your own words, I invite you, with your hands over your heart, to make a personal call for redemption of a freedom you're seeking in your own life. Do so now. Remember that if at any point those who hold on to darkness get their grip on you, you can always close your eyes and come back to this moment when your heart expanded its capacity to believe in the unknown and in the miraculous. And when you connected to the miracles of our nation from our past and from our future, thank you for your presence, for bringing more divine light and consciousness into this physical plane. And for believing in the power of your consciousness to change the world. When you're ready, I invite you to wiggle your fingers and wiggle your toes. Slowly come back into your body and open your eyes. And if you would like to do so, you can turn on your camera so we can bask in the glow of what we've created here. I bless you with a beautiful day. I bless you with a Shabbat of Shalom. I bless the entire Jewish people with only good news. So much love from South Africa.